I'd like to share a story that Frances told me that takes place well before her humanitarian work. Before Stella Adler taught her how to break down a script, before Lee Strasberg and his teachers taught her how to develop talent, before becoming a member of the Actors Studio. I was 19, working as a secretary for Firestone Rubber and Latex Company in Orange, Texas. I was asked to audition for the Orange Community Players production of Summer and Smoke, The Ingenue, and I got it. Needless to say, when the 4 o'clock whistle blew, something in me woke up as I scrambled to change from my pantsuit to my jeans and dashed down to the theater to rehearse the great words of Tennessee Williams until 10 o'clock at night. Retired actor John Holland told me I had talent. He saw me during the run, and he encouraged me to get out of town and to follow my passion. I had become aware of the flame inside, and acting is what fanned it. Over a 40-year career, and then Frances gasped, and she said, I can't believe it. I've watched the actors playing my kids grow up to be stars. I've watched first-time directors get their first big features. I've always looked forward to seeing what's around the corner, and I believe that the best is yet to come. So on that day Frances and I sat down together, she said about love, she said, it comes and it goes, and I don't think it ever disappears, but it has to be tapped into. Well, Frances Fisher, you've clearly shown with your grace and with your extraordinary work that you have tapped into it, and in doing that, have tapped into the hearts of millions of people around the world. And on behalf of AFFMA and the Arpa International Film Festival, I'd like to present to you the 15th Annual Career Achievement Award.
More love than I've ever felt in my life, and I feel the wisdom that will carry me through. So thank you so much.